This is not space, and these are not stars. In fact, these are a specific type of floaters in someone's eyeball. This condition actually has a fitting name called asteroid hyalosis. And the most surprising thing about this condition is what people see, what they experience with asteroid hyalosis. Let's focus in. Now, believe it or not, there are actually two similar conditions that have similar presentations. One, asteroid hyalosis, and one called scintillating scintillans or synchysis scintillans. So let's go over exactly what these two are. Asteroid hyalosis is considered a rare condition with maybe 1-2% of the population, with most of those cases being in the ages of 65 or older. And a lot of studies show that more men may have it than women. It's usually presented in just one eye, unilateral, and one eye doesn't have any at all. And these little floaters are made up of a calcium lipid white or yellow-white particles or asteroid bodies. And it really does have the appearance of shiny reflective dots within someone's eye that kind of looks like you're staring off into space looking at the stars. Now, these little particles are actually attached to the vitreous framework of the eye, attached to the gel of the inner eye. When someone moves their eyes, the floaters can float back and forth and kind of returns to the same position within that framework of the gel. Now, a surprising thing with asteroid hyalosis, the cause of it is mostly unknown. It can be associated with diabetes, but how those particles actually get in the eye is a mystery. Now, synchysis scintillans, a little bit different, but also similar. Synchysis scintillans, a little bit more rare than asteroid hyalosis, and it can be typically found in a younger population, maybe in the 30s and 40s, and this can commonly be found bilateral. You'll find it in both eyes. There might be one eye that has a little bit more of a presentation than the other eye. And these particles are made up of pretty much pure cholesterol. These are cholesterol floaters in the eye. And these particles are also shiny and reflective, but more gold. It almost looks like flakes of gold in someone's eye. And like asteroid hyalosis, can be stunning to look at through the microscope. Now, unlike asteroid hyalosis, synchysis scintillans, those particles are actually free-floating within the vitreous, so meaning they're not attached to the gel framework of the eye. And this almost has a presentation like someone shakes up a snow globe. If someone moves their eye, it's almost like someone shook a snow globe, and you'll see the particles kind of float around, and then generally with gravity will slowly settle to the bottom or closer to the bottom of the eye. It can be associated with more severe eye conditions like severe diabetic retinopathy or maybe a chronic inflammation like a uveitis. And so there are some additional things that an eye doctor needs to rule out. But just like asteroid hyalosis, the underlying cause is kind of unknown why it shows up. Now, like I said in the beginning of the video, let's go over the most surprising part about these conditions, specifically asteroid hyalosis. What do people see? In fact, most people with asteroid hyalosis don't even notice that there are that many floaters in their eye. They can be completely asymptomatic and not even notice these floaters in their vision. And to hammer this part home, why this is so unique, look at these two pictures right here. One with asteroid hyalosis and one with normal vitreous floaters. By looking at the pictures, which one do you think the patient would notice more in their vision? Which types of floaters? Automatically, we would say, hey, the asteroid hyalosis looks like it's getting in the way a lot more than the normal floaters. But in most cases, 9 times out of 10, this one with the normal vitreous floaters, the patient is more symptomatic and the floaters bug them way more than asteroid hyalosis. That is what makes this so interesting. Now, the same thing can be said for synchysis scintillans. A lot of patients can be completely asymptomatic, not even notice the floaters in there, but it seems like more patients with synchysis scintillans do tend to notice or have more symptoms of the floaters being in their vision or causing a disruption in the clarity of their vision as well. With asteroid hyalosis, you can have mild, moderate, and sometimes severe cases where you have a lot of a presentation of those asteroid bodies and the patient doesn't even know that they're there. They're completely asymptomatic. But when we look at them, we see a lot of floating particles, almost to the point where it blocks the vision, blocks our vision, our image or view of looking at the back part of their eye to adequately determine the health of their eye. Sometimes it can block our view. So in a lot of cases, the asteroid hyalosis is more detrimental or more annoying to the eye doctor than it is the patient. Now, as far as treatment goes for asteroid hyalosis, it is a benign condition. So in most cases, even mild, moderate, or some severe cases, it's not necessary to do anything because a lot of times the patient is asymptomatic and it's not bothering them. But in some cases, in the most severe cases where a patient is symptomatic, there is an option for something called a vitrectomy, where they can actually go in there and remove the vitreous or the gel of the eye and take the floaters with it. And the same treatment can be offered for those patients with synchysis scintillans. Same type of scenario. A lot of times it's not needed or not necessary, but if it's really messing with the patient's vision, that is an option. Now, with synchysis scintillans, there are other things that we need to rule out and look for and make sure that the eye is healthy, make sure that there's not a reason or another reason that that is showing up, that synchysis scintillans is showing up. To learn more specifics about floaters, check out my playlist right here. Floaters is definitely one of the most common things talked about in the clinic. I hope you learned something. If you have any questions, leave it in the comments below. I'm Dr. Neil Guyman, Dr. Eye Guy. Stay focused.